It may seem difficult to swallow at first, but believe it or not, this substantial 25-foot-long lorry is in fact a motor caravan, or if you want that in American, which is after all where it comes from, a motor home. The Superior 2500, which is what this vehicle is called, is really a very impressive beast indeed. Starting off at one of the two blunt ends, here, under the bonnet, houses a massive 7.2-litre Dodge V8 engine, coupled with all the advantages of power steering and braking and automatic transmission. Mind you, with all this weight to tote around, especially as it's at its cruising speed of 70 miles an hour, a fuel consumption figure of between 8 and 10 to the gallon is not really very surprising. It really is enormous. It's 8 feet wide and over 10 feet high. And in this country, it's only available in left-hand drive form. From the front, an extremely comfortable driving position. It even has a collapsible swivelling TV aerial for optimum reception. Well, as you'd rather expect, there's a fridge and a deep freeze thrown in with the price, which, wait for it, is about £10,000 on the road. Yet, despite that and the alarmingly high fuel consumption, over 100 American motorhomes were sold in this country last year, and the distributors certainly hope to top that in 1974. Mind you, if it's a mere £4,000 or so that you're prepared to part with, then take a look at the latest from Mercedes. This is the Ultra Autobahn, and it's powered by the well-known Mercedes 2.2-litre diesel under there, which it's claimed can deliver up to 30 miles to the gallon. Of course, all the extras you'd expect from that sort of price are there too, like the cooker and the fridge and the loo and the shower. And here's a good idea. On each side underneath, two large plastic water tanks with the water level easily visible there through that translucent strip. The Autobahn is actually converted in England by Barry Ban of Devon using the Mercedes L206D van base. It works out at about 6 feet wide and just over 17 feet long, which makes it slightly more sizeable than the British contender, the Olympian, comma-based by Haylett of Wiltshire. The 1725cc four-cylinder engine gives about 26 to the gallon overall, and this type of elevating roof four-berth construction puts the Olympian squarely into the most popular category of motor caravans for the home market. Inside, the day seating as here converts into the double bed, and up in the elevating roof are two of these, pull across and clip on bunk beds. The Super Deluxe model as here is fully carpeted throughout and comes with a little mini cooker over there with its own grill, there's a sink, rather attractive louver cupboard doors and a mini fridge down at the end. Now there are five Olympian models in all. There's the Deluxe and the Super Deluxe, and you can have them with either fixed or elevating roofs, plus a model called the High Top. Mechanical options include overdrive, automatic transmission, or a high compression engine. And a mid-range Olympian with some of these extras would set you back a shade over the £2,000 mark. Newest of all on the scene over here is the tiny Danbury Huntsman, which at about £1,500 is claimed to be the cheapest motor caravan on sale here in the UK. It boasts here at the back a tiny 903cc engine, which should give you about 35 miles to the gallon. But when you're dealing with something of this size, the phrase motor caravan is really a bit ambitious. The Huntsman is much more of a dual-purpose vehicle for short-distance overnight stays, that sort of thing. It's based on the Fiat 850T van and will just sleep three. But it's only 12 foot two long. Or, to put it another way, you could get two of them inside the Superior with comfort and with lots of room to spare. Well, with me here now is Tony Wilson of Europe's biggest motor caravan dealers. Tony, first of all, as the fuel crisis seems to be with us on a more or less permanent basis, how are sales?
Well, sales were depressed at the beginning of the year, but they've picked up tremendously now.
What would you say to the chap who said, whatever use to me is a motor caravan for the other 49 weeks of the year when I'm not on holiday?
Well, a lot of people use motor caravans for business use, use them for weekends, for visiting relatives, going to sporting events.
So they really are quite useful?
Oh, they're very useful, yes.
Lots of them can be bought in very basic form, but are there certain extras which you would insist that everybody really ought to have?
Depends on the motor caravan. You've got very luxuriously fully equipped ones, and then you've got the cheaper ones where with less space inside, and an annex tent would be very useful.
that sort of thing?
That's right.
And a fridge?
A fridge, yes, definitely.
Very handy indeed.
Yes.
What about the chap who says, I don't want to pay all this money, I'll buy an ordinary van and do it myself?
There's a number of people who do this, and there are conversion kits available for them. They have to be careful how they convert these vehicles because they have to comply with certain regulations, otherwise they pay car tax.
And talking about car tax brings me onto the subject of depreciation. How does the motor caravan depreciate?
Well, it's car tax free and its depreciation is lower than the average family car.
Tony Wilson, I'm very obliged to you. Thank you.
Thank you.